strongly on the outside, Creative Talent, base 2 of 4 by base clear of Fear Bay. Onshore Javelins is running on with an Albert Road as Creative Talent moves alongside Nanamore. Base 2 now race towards the final 150 yards. Pressure sitting between them. Onshore Javelins is running on. They're well inside the final 100 yards in the centre. Creative Talent, Nanamore on the inside is battling on strongly. The Northwood Malai head to head. Nanamore on the inside. And Lee Rhodes, they made the breakthrough. Creative Talent and Onshore Javelins. And close behind them in fourth, Fear Bay. Beginning the climb to the home turn, and Nanamore with coming there strongly on the outside, Creative Talent, these two are 4 or 5 lengths clear of Fear Vane. Onshore Javelins is running on, and then Albert Road as Creative Talent moves alongside Nanamore. These two now race towards the final 150 yards, pressure sitting between them. Onshore Javelins is running on, they're well inside the final 100 yards in the centre. Creative Talent, Nanamore on the inside is battling on strongly. They're going towards the line, head to head. Nanamore on the inside, and Lee Rhodes, they've made the breakthrough. Creative Talent and Onshore Javelins, and close behind them in fourth, Fear Bay. Racing now towards the home turn. The CM between horses. Marie Celeste, our racing mates, ground on the outside. Nicaragua is just in behind them with Recollection. Racing now towards the final furlong, and as they begin to straighten up, it's Fassi on the inside of Recollection. In the centre is our Rager. Recollection on the outside of Nicaragua, who's coming there between horses as Marie Celeste weakens well inside the final furlong now. And the spread across the track, and Recollection of Nicaragua, they flash by! Recollection on the near side of Nicaragua. And our Rager close with them, and Fassi on the rail. They're clear from Marie Celeste. Racing now towards the home turn. Fassi in between horses. Marie Celeste, our Rachel, makes ground on the outside. Nicaragua is just in behind them with Recollection. Racing now towards the final furlong, and as they begin to straighten up, it's Fassi on the inside of Recollection. In the centre is our Rachel. Recollection on the outside of Nicaragua, who's coming there between horses as Marie Celeste weakens well inside the final furlong now. And the spread across the track, and Recollection of Nicaragua, they flash past! Recollection on the near side of Nicaragua, and our Rager close with them, and Fassi on the rail. They're clear from Marie Celeste. Beginning the climb towards the home turn. Three colours red and Rory Cleary in front with coming to challenge Pink Code and Frank Berry on the outside. Racing round the home turn now, and Pink Code on the outside in the grey colours looms alongside the long-time leader. Three colours red, Secundus out is in third. Beginning now to race towards the final 150 yards, and Pink Code is the leader going on from three colours red and Secundus out. And well inside the final 100 yards, it's Pink Code from three colours red trying to come back, but Pink Code will follow up and beat three colours red, a length and a half between them. Secundus out third, clear of coin gate four. Beginning the climb towards the home turn. Three colours red and Rory Cleary in front with coming to challenge Pin Code and Frank Berry on the outside. Racing round the home turn now, and Pin Code on the outside in the grey colours looms alongside the long-time leader. Three colours red, Secundus out is in third. Beginning now to race towards the final 150 yards, and Pin Code is the leader going on from three colours red and Secundus out. And well inside the final 100 yards, it's Pin Code from three colours red trying to come back, but Pin Code will follow up and beat three colours red, a length and a half between them. Secundus out third, clear of coy big four. Outside. Then Mind the Pennies and Broco Ponder was just in behind. Rockview Emperor is trying to recover. Into the straight they come, a furlong to go. High Kicker on the rally, but on the near side of the checks, Mademoiselle Penny. Mind the Pennies, Broco Ponder, Rockview Emperor and Duke of Medina. They're well inside the final 150 yards. Mademoiselle Penny on the near side of High Kicker. They're going towards the line, stride for stride, Broco Ponder. Mademoiselle Penny in the centre, and on the inside, High Kicker, Broco Ponder is third, and then a gap to Mind the Pennies. is High Kicker and Mademoiselle Penny on the outside. Then Mind the Pennies and Broco Pondo is just in behind. Rockview Emperor is trying to recover. Into the straight they come, a furlong to go. High Kicker on the rail, but on the near side in the checks, Mademoiselle Penny. Mind the Pennies, Broco Pondo, Rockview Emperor and Duke of Medina. They're well inside the final 150 yards. Mademoiselle Penny on the near side of High Kicker. They're going towards the line, stride for stride, and Broco Pondo. Mademoiselle Penny in the center, and on the inside, High Kicker, Broco Pondo is third, and then a gap to Mind the Pennies. Bob Skier, Shane Foley with Henry's Girl moving up there smoothly in between horses for Flanberry. On their outside is Carrie and Colin Keane racing out towards the home turn, and Henry's Girl picks it up. And followed by Kelly and Bob Skier, get out of jail is next in fourth as they reach the furlong pole. And Henry's Girl has gone for home and got away from Kelly and then Bob Skier and get out of jail. And racing deep in the closing stages of the Christine Hatfield Memorial Handicap, it's Henry's Girl out in front, wins by three. It's a winner for John Carley and a double for Glenn Benny. Henry's Girl beats Kelly. Bob Skier about 4 or 5 lengths away from third. Get out of jail, fallen, take off Oceana Queen. Racing towards the final 2 furlongs on the home turn. Bob Skier, Shane Foley with Henry's Girl moving up there smoothly in between horses for Flanberry. On their outside is Carrie and Colin Keane racing now towards the home turn, and Henry's Girl picks it up. And followed by Carrie and Bob Skier, get out of jail is next in fourth as they reach the furlong pole. And Henry's Girl has gone for home and got away from Carrie and then Bob Skier and get out of jail. And racing deep in the closing stages of the Christine Hatfield Memorial Handicap, it's Henry's Girl out in front, wins by three. It's a winner for John Carley and a double for Glenn Benny. Henry's Girl beats Caddy. Bob Skier about 4 or 5 lengths adrift from third. Get out of jail, fallen, tailed off Oceana Queen. Hunting Tower is in third. These three have gone away from the others as Magnetic Force is driven to the front by Colin Keane and lengthens away from Hunting Tower. Mr. Bossman is in third and racing now just outside the 100-yard marker. Clear as Magnetic Force has settled in strides under Colin Keane, and at the line, Magnetic Force runs out a fine winner from Mr. Bossman. Hunting Tower, Burnt Sienna, Windward Passage next. Straight they come. Hazaraban is the leader. From He Be Remembered and then Storm Away. Messini's Trap is fourth as they race to the final 150 yards. And it's Hazaraban in the lead from He Be Remembered. They're clear from Storm Away. Running up to the line, and Hazaraban stolen on the far side and completes a double for Shane Foley. Beats He Be Remembered. Storm Away in third. And in fourth place, Messini's Trap.